Stretched it too far.
Delivering cargo. Delivery complete. Displaying performance evaluation. Thank you for your continued support. Good work. New order available. Please access delivery terminal for further information.
Thank you, Sam. In reclaiming our past, we've uncovered a number of vital clues. Don't worry, I just got back. We have time. When you met with Mama, you experienced a strong antigen-antibody reaction, correct?
There was a BT in the room.
There was, but something else may have been causing it. I've discovered large quantities of chiral matter in Mama as well. Not just the usual kind that collects on our skin or on our suits. It's in all her cells. Cells that are no longer active. The BT you encountered there was special. It was her child, but also her own soul. Somehow, her Ka and Ha failed to separate. They must have remained connected through the umbilical cord. It's the only explanation.
Is that why I didn't get a bruise where she touched me?
Yes. And there's more.
10 seconds to cardiac arrest. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
I modified the log times. Headquarters will have no record of what we say. Look, a message from Deadman. It came with the umbilical cord.
Sam, I'm sorry. You deserve to know what you were carrying. But I couldn't risk Die Hardman finding out about the case. So I had no choice but to keep it off the books. You've got to keep this between us. We still don't know if the director can be trusted. The umbilical cord was taken from Bridget Strand. I removed it in secret. The cord wasn't attached to a fetus. It was outside her body. She asked me to take care of it. Said it was the key to unlocking the Death Stranding. But she insisted that I never tell the director. The cord shows no sign of decomposition or necrotization. Almost as if it's frozen in time. I thought Hartman might be able to make sense of it, so I had it hidden with your cargo at Mountain Knot City.
Deadman's observations were accurate. It's just like Mama's corpse.
What do you mean?
I mean they share a very unique property. Both contain large amounts of Corellium in their cells. In other words, the president's cord was somehow connected to the beach, and that allowed it to escape the flow of time. I've put together the bones of a theory. It's patchy, but worth sharing, I think. Life on Earth has been rocked by many extinctions, great and small, including the Big Five. And if you examine the Earth's strata, its history, if you will, you'll find Corellium deposits that can be dated to each. What if the manifestation of beaches and other associated phenomena correspond to extinction-level events?
You mean?
Yes. Our Death Stranding could just be the latest of many. The records and research you helped us to recover strongly suggest that we are in the middle of the sixth extinction.
Sixth extinction? Come on.
You know what this is, yes?
A frozen mammoth from 10,000 years ago.
Correct. And this?
The Iceman from 5,300 years ago.
They both had the same umbilical cords.
Bullshit.
Humor me. What if the mammoth and the Iceman weren't frozen?
You're saying time stopped for them just like it did for Mama?
Unfortunately, all these specimens were lost in the Death Stranding, so there's no way to examine the genuine articles. But some fragments of data did survive. With the aid of the chiral network, we may be able to piece together something more concrete using Evo-Devo tech. All right, how's this? A dinosaur from 65.5 million years ago. Umbilical cord, not decomposed.
Only mammals have umbilical cords.
No. Only mammals have umbilical cords used for childbirth. This is something else. Call it a strand from the other side. I propose that mammalian umbilici are a sort of mimesis of the strand that then evolved over time. We shouldn't assume that everything about a Death Stranding is detrimental to life. Trilobites, ammonites, dinosaurs, the mammoth, the Iceman, all preserved as if frozen in time, all without exception, found with strands, which is to say that all may have been connected to the beach. And this, when viewed in the context of the extinction entity, EE theory, leads me to surmise that organisms with strands are in fact extinction entities. You see, Sam, EEs are connected to the beach via their strands. And it is through this connection that they somehow bring about a Death Stranding.
So you're saying Bridget was an extinction entity?
It's far too soon to say anything for certain. And since you burned her body, we may never know.
Hicks said Amelie's an EE, that she doesn't have dooms like the rest of us.
Sam, think. Assume that President Strand was an EE. Isn't it possible that her daughter is too? At the very least, Higgs may hope as much now that the president is unavailable.
So he kidnaps her for EE powers or whatever to cause a mass extinction?
Perhaps, perhaps not. I doubt a single EE is powerful enough to cause a Death Stranding, assuming Amelie is an EE.
Well, Higgs sure thinks she's got what it takes.
Indeed. And we need to get her back as soon as possible.
1 minute remaining. Please hold on to something secure.
Ah, this one is real. Sam, go west.
How do you want me to handle Die Hardman?
With your customary reserve. Nothing good will come of him learning of our suspicions. Whatever else is going on, we still need the chiral network.
Right.
Activating lab security measures. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
It's time, Sam. When you're ready, proceed to the shore of the Tar Belt and begin work on the chiral relay. Once it's ready, use the Cupid to bring it online. The necessary materials are prepped for you. Supplies are limited, so handle them with care. You'll be carrying a lot, too. All things considered, this might be one of your hardest runs to date. Hartman knows more about the site than I do, so he'll take it from here. It's about time for his wake-up call, anyway.
Administering shock. Stand clear.
Right. About that way station. The site we have chosen was an original candidate for the way station we lost to the Tar Belt. Ironically, we suspended construction because we deemed it a little too unstable and not worth the risk. But this time, it's our best shot. So let's hope we weren't right to change horses in midstream. Fortunately for us, the foundation we laid down is still intact. All you have to do is transport the necessary materials to the site and finish the job. I'm afraid it's the only way we can expand the network further west and rescue Amelie. We're counting on you, Sam.
Thank you.
Keep on keeping up. Keep on keeping up.
you there. Bridges wants you.
Let's go.
get those materials processed in order to finish the Chiral Relay. Good job, Sam. Now access the terminal and bring the relay online. Once you cross the tar belt, the end will be in sight. We're this close to Emily, to America's second chance. Edgenot City awaits. The staff we're sending will start by building a safe house. Over time, they'll expand their operations and establish a new facility. In doing so, they'll carry on the legacy of the brave souls lost to the tar. All thanks to you, Sam. Now, let's figure out how to get you across this tar belt.
Keep on keeping on. only way west is through that. To make matters worse, I don't believe your PCC is capable of building anything that will get you across. There must be a way. We can't give up, not with what's at stake. We'll see if we can't think of something here. But considering everything you've been through, I wouldn't be surprised if you've already got a few ideas of your own.
Sorry, kid. Hello.